Okay, thanks so much to the audience. We really didn't think there would be so many people here. You guys are obviously not hungry or have eaten or plan to sleep in this nice AC room. But let's just jump into our session, which has already been delayed. This first question to Sid, who runs his own fabulously unique studio, which connects producers and studios with content. So just tell me, how exciting has it been since this is a very recent development in the film industry and TV industry and digital industry in India? How's that been?
Yeah, so it's been a very exciting, I would say, the last 18 months. I think there's been a big change in perception that's happened, you know, in our industry. And overnight, producers who never read scripts saying, "Koi achhi book hai kya?" And, you know, it's suddenly, like, you know, it's like a culture shock for me, because I get calls every day from all kinds of producers, directors, even screenplay writers, saying, "Is there a good story? Is there a good book that we can adapt?" Of course, you know, it's not that easy that every book that gets sold or gets optioned will turn into something. But, you know, this itself is a great move, I think, for the industry, where development of stories was never given its due importance, commercially and creatively. And this whole change of thought has opened up, I think, a large amount of opportunities for genuine writers. And I am a big fan of writers who write novels, big fan of authors, because I think their writing has a lot of depth, research, worlds and characters, which, you know, I feel, you know, the usual commercial writers that we've had in our, you know, industry are sort of never paid that much importance to. And it was always, you know, let's just get the job done, while authors sit alone for maybe years and they write something. So, you know, I feel this collaboration that started now, wherein, you know, there is a core writer that which I call source material, a book, and then other writers, directors will keep collaborating on those stories, will eventually lead to better stories and more insightful stories, more engaging stories. So I think for everybody as a whole, it's a whole new world that has sort of started now. So I think we've got many years now to sort of build on this.
So for Anand and Shatru, both of you, when, I mean, today when you all are writing books, and you already know now for the last, say, 1.5 odd years, and, you know, people have announced a lot of books to screen projects, the digital channels as well as certain films have been announced by studios, by prominent filmmakers. When you sit to write content, and each of you needs to answer this, how much does that play on your head when you're actually writing that, acha, ye shayad kal jaake picture banegi, or it's going to become a web show or something? I mean, does that play in your head? How much does it play?
For me, not really. But actually, what I realized happened is that since I wrote my book after 2 decades of screenwriting, in a way, it was in the same format. So much so that when the editor looked at the book, he said, "But there's no description of the heroine or the hero." I said, "Haan, wo toh director karega na, jab casting karega." So, you know, it just spills over. But the flip of that is it's written almost like an edited script. Whereas with books, I guess, people who are purely authors, it's a different medium altogether. And like Sid said, the detailing and the going into the internal thought processes of the characters, that's a lot more, which then would have to be changed when you turn it into a script. So, like that.
Yeah, I think being an author in India, there are some exceptions like this gentleman who's sitting here. But otherwise, you know, by and large, being an author in India, you really can't sustain a lifestyle by selling books. As they say, ghar ka chula nahi chalne wala. So the thing is that for me, and I think this is true for a lot of authors who have been writing for the last probably 8-10 years, the dream is that, you know, I get this book out and hopefully somebody would acquire the rights. Okay, that's really where, you know, there is a likelihood of a jackpot. Okay. And probably that's where you make the most amount of money, and you know, in your lifetime sales, you don't probably make that kind of money. So definitely for most pure play authors, this turn that we've seen over the last 2 years is like, you know, suddenly it's like chappad phadke, you know, somebody's like, "Whoa, wow, there's actually opportunity." Previously there was just a dream, now there's more than just a dream. So yes, definitely, I think a lot of authors have always wanted to get their books adapted into some format or the other. Okay, previously it was only movies. Now we've got web shows and all of that. So I really think, writing itself has in that sense probably changed a little bit. It has become a little more visual. That's also probably because we consume a lot more visual stories. Our storytelling consumption is visual, so we also tell more visual stories. But I definitely think it's true. Somewhere in the back of your mind, there is that isko bechna hai, paise banana hai. So, yeah.
Okay, so Anand has been a filmmaker, so it's, you know, easier for him to have written in a way, and there's also a possibility that he could also choose to direct his own book or, you know, have some kind of control over that. But if you are a pure author, and how much control? Because I think, I think Sid can also answer this, where when you're giving away your book rights, when you're optioning them away or selling them away, and Sid, we'd also like to know the difference between the optioning and the selling. But when you're doing that and you're parting with your material, how much is the temptation to be in control of your characters and your story?
Yeah, I completely agree. In fact, the funny bit is that my own book, which has gone out for adaptation, I am not adapting it. Because I realize that if I get into that, I will be hampering a process. I do not want the author of some book that I am adapting to come and tell me ki kya karna hai isme. You have written your book, you have done a good job, you have done a great job. Now let me do the job of taking this forward to a different medium. I think I must respect the same thing for another scriptwriter rather than me poking my nose inside. So this is actually true, but it's also difficult. I completely agree. It is very difficult because you want to have creative control. Nahi, aisa nahi hai, aisa hota hai, all that kind of stuff. It's always there. But I think if you're a mature person, you kind of sit back and say, you know, it's hota hai, and you might not be happy with the end product. I mean, the famous Saving Mr. Banks. I think it's one of the best movies that's been on adaptations. On it's outstanding about how, you know, this Walt Disney and the author of not Sound of Music. I forget the name of the book. Mary Poppins, and about how they have this entire ego tussle about, you know, what the creative product should be and what the final product should be. So it's great. It's difficult, but you have to do it. I mean, it's for the betterment, larger good of your project.
So I must add to this, because Shatru and, you know, we've collaborated, and he's written two pitch Bibles based on books written by other authors. And we are on the third one. And as you said, his book is being adapted by somebody else. So actually it adds, because I think, you know, the key to, I think in this world, collaboration is very key now. It is really important to build the right team. And that team building continues right up to the shoot, right? So everybody's important in the chain. So I think if you can respect and collaborate, the product becomes really much better. And I think, the author whose book he turned into a Bible, we met, both of you met for the first time last year at PILF. Yeah, and it was awkward moment, but it was fun.
It would have been more awkward if he had seen what I had done for the proc.
So he keeps telling me, can I read it? And I'm saying, wait, right? But the thing is, I think being a third person, I think the material has really like sort of been enhanced. So I think it's a great collaborative process.
Sorry, also because it's completely like, you know what Chatur said, it's a different medium. From paper, you're going into an audiovisual 3D. But yeah, Anand?
No, what I just wanted to add on was, like, we've done, as a company, we've done two adaptations of books. And in both cases, the author was involved. But the author understood that now this is becoming a series. So the same grammar, etc., cannot apply. You know, so he actually gave us complete latitude in adding characters, adding subplots, putting in... See, also, the nature of a series is you need hooks. Otherwise, nobody's coming for the next episode. So you're creating random stuff that wasn't there in the source material. And somewhere an author has to be open to that. Varna, koi dekhega nahi.
Yeah, so basically what you're saying is adding all the masala. Which need possibly the author didn't intend.
Which may not have been part of his original vision altogether.
At all, yeah.
But it's great when the author says, okay, now this is a different medium. Now it's a different audience. So maybe my fans who love the book will watch. But we're targeting an audience who's not familiar with the book at all and who need to be held for 9-10 episodes. So...
But then, okay, so I'm also going to ask you, Anand, because you've been on both sides. And then, Shatru, you've been on the side of screenwriting and also been an author. How, and a very edgy question, but how ethical is it to dilute material that already has a fan base? You know, for example, I'm going to go out on a limb now, but when I saw the first Harry Potter, it just messed with me because in my head, I was imagining a completely different universe. So I didn't see any of the others, because I was like, I don't want to, mereko dekhna hi nahi hai ye. And then when you see films that are done really nicely and they're in sync with what you've imagined when you were reading, it's just beautiful when you see it and you're very happy. But how does that play, you know, the ethics of that with the fans of it, of the book?
See, as a script writer or a director, your first loyalty is to the watching audience, not to the book reading audience. And your ethics are there, that this has to get that audience, has to hook them. It has to get people to watch the 10 episodes or make 20 crores on opening weekend. Woe is your this thing. You cannot possibly think about that the books ke fans ko unke aisa pasand aaya tha, because wo books ke fans aayenge, nahi aayenge, you have no clue. And ultimately you're getting paid by the producer. So
yeah, also just adding to that, you know, the sample size is actually a big difference. The millions who watch content on screen and the people who buy books and read, there's a big difference in that population. Right? I mean,
yeah, absolutely. I think Sacred Gems is a great case in point. Yeah. The number of people who've seen the show as opposed to the number of people who must have read the book.
Yeah.
World of difference.
Yeah. No? You wanna add something? So what are the most popular genres, Sid, that, you know, in the last 18 months that you've been in this new exciting content collaboration business? What have you found the most popular genre?
Well, you know, 90% of the inquiries come for episodic content. So for that, it's usually plots that have a thriller, mystery, sort of, you know, those genres or those kind of stories are most suited for that format of episodic binge. So that's been the main focus. And then in that, there are, you know, variations, right? So it could be a thriller set in the past or in the present, or, you know, in science fiction, a couple of books. So, but primarily there needs, this whole binge has become the big currency that people want to encash. And so stories that can sort of can service that are most in demand.
Is there anything more you guys want to add, or we can throw it open for Q&A?
You're out of questions.
I think I'm out of questions completely. Ho gaya na? Mere ko to pura pata hai. Tum logon ko kuch puchna hai?
This is for Sid. You said he sold about 75 plus books for adaptation. So what's the minimum, maximum, and the median?
You mean money?
Money.
No. Ab to income tax come down, no? So I can share it. So I would say 80% of the books, they go in the range of 20 to 35 lakhs. And 20% are higher than a crore. What I usually try and do is peg it to the scale of the project. So that way it's a very fair and equitable solution that comes forward. But yeah, that's the broad range.
I think Jyoti had a question on optioning, the difference between optioning and selling. Would you want to kind of clarify that as well?
It's technical. Yeah, I mean, I'll just, okay. So option is basically an option to buy in a certain period at a certain fixed price. And so it's not an obligation for the buyer to buy the rights. He pays a small advance, which is non-refundable usually. And then he gets a time, about a year or so, to put the project together. And if the project doesn't happen for some reason, his money is forfeited. And the writer can sell the rights to somebody else. And in a sale, it's a direct sale.
Hi, Sid, for you again. Typically, when we look at a bookshelf nowadays, the Indian writing bit, the kind of writing that we see which secures shelf space surely is, you know, a lot of mythology, mythological fiction. Then there's your chick lit. There's a whole lot of current affairs stuff. You know, it could be well written or not, but they find shelf space. Similarly, when it comes to adapting books to screen, how open and how, you know, how much are you all actually looking at stories that are perhaps not centered around Bombay and around Metro India or the Metropolitan? Because are you looking at, you know, back of the beyond stories, open to other genres, or do you play safe and stick to these narratives that...
No, so, you know, the good thing is that now people have realized that the audiences want better, compelling stories, relatable stories, different stories. So I think what really happens is that from the day producers start thinking, oh, we need to focus on story, and by the time stories start coming out for the audiences, there's about a 18 to 24 month lag. So I would say next year, you will see a wide variety of stories getting made. And this year, not as much, because it does take time. And this whole focus sort of came about last year. But, you know, as I said, right, digital has made also Middle India very interesting. Regional content, I think, will explode at some point soon. So I think there'll be all kinds of producers focusing on different genres, different scale of stories, different creators, but largely the premium suppliers of content, the big players, they will do the usual big stuff, and maybe the smaller players will focus. Like, for example, there's a company called Hoi Choi, which is Bengali content. Exactly. So that's a great example of how they're focusing on stories from there. So I think there should be more Hoi Choi's from different regions. Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's a great platform.
Hi. I couple of questions, actually. So I have four novels which are getting converted into pitch. I also have a couple of manuscripts that are getting converted into pitches. But what I was wondering, and it's a question more to Sid and to all three of you, actually, that is the pitch Bible enough? As in, if I have an idea, I mean, if I have an idea, which is not yet a novel, but it's not even a manuscript yet, but it's just an idea. And is the pitch Bible enough to start with? I mean, we are going beyond novel to
broadly, if you look at how projects get greenlit in the screen industry, right? There are two ways of doing it. One is you are a name talent who's done something in the past. And then if you go with an idea or a pitch Bible, they'll say, theek hai, they have faith in you, you've proven yourself. So you have a good chance of getting greenlit. But if you're not a name talent and if you're a new talent, then you have to create enough vision and treatment for people to imagine what it could become. Because in our industry, people don't have great imagination, unfortunately. So, you know, they will judge material from what it is, not from what it could become. Like, what I usually do is that I focus on that, is to help them figure what it could become. So if your Bible, so if it's a published book, right, then the burden of what it could become is not on you. Your job is done. And it's published, it's in the public domain, there are reviews. Then it's easy, then, you know, it's the producer's job to figure what it can become, or my problem, not yours. So I would say if you can write a book, write it and get it out of the way. And then don't take the burden of development. It's hell.
I'll add one thing to what you're saying. Just yesterday, I was in a meeting with a producer, and we spent about 40 minutes discussing everything, the content, the pitch, Bible, ye. And then he turns around and says, but actually, na, if we can figure ki ye main character ka casting kaun hoga and get one actor involved, ye to ek hafte mein bik jayega. So ultimately, that part is always there. Like, there's a platform which I will not name because I've got three projects, hopefully, which will happen with them. I don't want to get blacklisted. But there, the first thing you pitch is like, we can get so-and-so, we can get so-and-so.
Z5.
I didn't say it. He said it. So, but that's the way. It's absolutely that. I've got three projects there, which we're discussing. All three, the casting is the first thing that's got figured. In fact, in one of the concepts, I was told, acha, the story is great. Ab ye actor involved hone wala hai. Ab aap rewrite karo and fit this guy. And we've actually done that. The whole story's been turned on its head so that this character with this casting can be fitted.
But I'd like to defend the studio, you know, when they look at casting. I'm not against it. I'm saying all kinds of methods work. You know, the challenge is that we have a very distracted audience today. Engagement is the biggest problem. So first you have to break the clutter, get their, you know, attention, then engage them. So casting is the easiest way to get their attention, and then if a story is good, then you engage them. I mean, Hoi Choi does that. They get so many film actors to do their series, and you know, I think it's a great.
Yeah, completely works.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think it works even in the abroad. I mean, you've got so many shows which are actually which are headlined by very well known stars, and that's really
Big
what.
Big Little Lies.
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely.
But so there's no harm in attempting just the film Bible
I've seen. It's not about harm. I'm saying you need to have a solid strategy. I am not a big fan of, you know, just do anything randomly, because it's not a random business. It seems like a very random, chaotic business. It is, but it's also very, very logical, and very simple logic applies. So if you have the right access with the right talent, it's very easy to then do what you're doing.
My question is, yeah, this is George. So what's the scope of corporate style of storytelling kind of books? What's the scope you see there?
Corporate, I mean?
Like a movie based
the 5 a.m. club.
Yeah. And corporate, like a company based organization storytelling.
You mean stories set in the office?
Corporate
fictional
style.
Stories.
Yes.
I mean,
does it work?
It can work. Depends on how the writing is, what the story is. I think I believe India has an amazing audience. We watch anything as long as it gets our attention. We think it's value for our time and money. So as long as it fits those parameters and then you can get the packaging of a project, I think where it is set is not really a problem. I mean, I don't see that as a big challenge.
Okay.
Good afternoon. I've got a couple of questions anybody can answer. The first one though is for Mr. Jain. I think among your Instagram posts was a self-published book or a book published through Amazon. So is that something people are becoming more open to in the filmmaking and rather the web show business as far as adapting that is concerned? And secondly, do you think taking your time, because Amazon and Netflix are not doing that, taking your time will actually end up benefiting a lot of people where making shows is concerned, because they've suddenly, these two big giants have just put out a whole lot of stuff and a lot of it has just gotten panned and finished off. So what are your thoughts on that?
So what's your second part of the question?
Taking one's time with a source material.
You mean taking time to write it better?
Write it better, okay. Develop it, make it. I think Amazon has only really taken time with Kabir Khan's Forgotten Army. Everything else has almost been rushed through. So do you think it will end up serving people better in the long run?
Okay, so I'll answer. So the first part first. Yeah, actually there's a book called Avishi. And that book was picked up by a big studio, self-published book, not even a paperback, Kindle. It popped up on the popularity charts on Amazon. And I did that deal and it was a terrific deal because the author is unknown. And now she's got a paperback deal after that. So yeah, so good stories that can connect will pop up. Though I must say, if one has to go and pitch, physical books help. Because it's just easier to pitch things which people can touch, feel. They may not read, but they want to flip pages. So I feel a published book in hand is a great way to get people's attention. They put on the desk. Yeah, it's just a better tool. But if it's a good story, it's a good story. And not everybody reads a book, right, in our business. So one has to always keep reminding oneself that people read the 2-3 pages, which is the summary of the plot. And that's where you have to either get their attention or not. And the second part, yeah, I mean, of course, everybody should take as much time to make good shows. But unfortunately, there is a race in this country. You know, most media companies from Hollywood or from Europe can't enter China that easily. So in Asia, India is their play. And India is a very important market to get consumers, to get eyeballs. So nobody has patience. So everybody's trying their best to be as quick as possible. And that will mean not great content all the time. But that's part of the business. It's always been like this.
I must also say that I am writing a show for Amazon and we've been writing that thing forever. I mean, we've been writing and rewriting and writing and rewriting. It's either reflects very badly on us as writers or it shows very nicely on Amazon. But the fact of the matter is that they're taking a lot of time about it. They're really, really taking time. So I can speak only about this one project, but I don't think it's true that they're rushing. There would be projects that would be easier done. It also depends on what is at stake. You know, the higher the stakes, the more time they'll take. The lower the stakes, you know, it's just one of those things.
Also, let me just tell you guys, so for web series, especially, so if it's a movie, it's great because you're in and out and, you know, there's a book and it's like X number of pages, you adapt it into one screenplay, 2 hours, whatever, and people shoot it, get dates and, you know, it's shot in like 3 months, edit it, and it's out. But for web, especially digital, and that's such a big thing because you want to create seasons. You know, there's no point in buying content or creating content which is just going to be like 8 to 10 episodes and then it's over. So there's that investment in how far can this story go. So there's a lot of writers or aspiring writers need to, if your ambition is to then, you know, generate, monetize the content that you're making, is also investment into how far can my story go. So they're looking at different seasons, they're looking at X number of episodes per season. And then they shoot that, so it'll usually take about, really on an average, 3 years from the time it gets greenlit to the time it's, you know, written, produced, and brought out with, you know, they and all the channels, the smallest Indian channels to the biggest international players, know when to time their releases also. They can't, it's like feature films, you don't clash, you know, big films with each other because you're just, you know, dividing the market. So there's so much strategy and so much thought that goes into the business side of it that as authors, I mean, my, you know, very, very humble suggestion would be if any of you plan to get into this as a real, you know, career, is to also think how far can my, does my story have the potential to, you know, get that kind of interest where people can see, are ye kahani lambi ja sakti hai.
And after so much of effort and hard work and time, we still make crappy stuff. So it takes skill to do that.
Hi, 12 o'clock. My question is to all the three guests. You all kind of explained how a book can be treated further. What is your advice to the new writers who has not earned their names yet? How do they pitch their stories to the producers or the people who can take their work further?
So I just want to add that I don't think old and new is a big factor in the screen world.
Okay.
I would say 70% of the books that I have set up are unknown authors. People didn't know them, the producers didn't know them. So it doesn't matter. What matters is, I think practically, the title of your book, the cover of your book, the synopsis, the back of your book, and your plot in 3 pages. If as a writer you can crack that, along with the other hundreds of pages that you crack, I think that's the real factor to get ahead in the adaptation game.
Yeah, just for the record, there are only about 5 or 10 authors who are known. Okay. Just for the record.
Okay.
Okay, the rest of us are not known. Okay, so just, so it really doesn't count.
Thank you so much.
I have written a book called Ek Prayas Dharti Ke Chhor Par. This has been published by National Book Trust of India. Just now you just mentioned that book with good content. That is what people are looking for. Writer, producer, director, whatever way, whichever genre you are saying. So my wish is to present you this book today, coming on stage. Would you please accept it?
No, please don't disturb the session this, right now. You can catch him immediately.
You can
afterwards.
Just take my book. I'm just giving it to you.
Yeah,
what is the harm in it?
Yeah,
if one side pe you are encouraging people, organizing functions,
it's
2 minutes doesn't take much of a time.
This is a, so it's unfair to, there might be other questions.
So anybody else can ask the question. Anybody else can present the book.
Can we just do it? As soon as we're done, we'll call you, ma'am, we'll call you up. And let him give
okay,
it to you.
Okay,
yeah?
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
That is the way to help actually, yeah. If you are really into helping people. Thank you.
Hi, this is Abhishek here. Everyone says that India mein talent ki kami nahi hai, and I totally accept it because there is a cutthroat competition to get through. I'm very happy that there are platforms where a screenplay is being judged and an award is being done. But what about lyric writers? Like, I see that stories have changed in India. Like, the cinema has a different story. But what about songs? Because still it is remakes and remakes. That is not what reflects the true talent in India. So, something about lyric writers.
You know, we've got two amazing platforms, you know, that we have globally. YouTube and Facebook video. You know, I feel that today anybody who wants to showcase his talent can do it at no cost, collaborate with a good composer who's also up and coming, write your lyrics and it works, man. You know, I feel people don't use social media, internet enough these days. They're distracted, they're using social media, but they're not using, I use it so effectively for work and I'm happy to say that. And I think it's a great tool for anybody to get attention. We should stop complaining that, you know, there's no platform. When there was no internet, it was difficult to reach out to people. Today, I get inquiries on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook, links, and there's a lot of it, but I'm saying it's so accessible, it's so easy. I mean, you can't complain about that. I think just do it.
Hello. At the risk of getting mob lynch, I'm asking one question that I had a discussion with Shatrujit last year on the same. I'm not a big fan of adaptation. So my question is predominantly to Sid, is it because there is a lack of good screenplays coming out from the writers? Is that the reason we are moving more towards the adaptation?
Okay, so my thing is that I don't, so okay, so I think in our industry generally, there isn't enough talent that is able to fulfill the needs of the business in the way they want it, which also means that there is no harm in expanding the choices. So I think what Books is doing is basically expanding the choices, and sometimes screenwriters like him collaborate. So it's not as if, it's just, I think it's good to have more so one can pick better, because everybody's different choice, different aesthetic.
But is that your cycle? There is more.
It's faster. So I'll tell you what the difference is, right? Today, if you tell me that I have this idea, it's a two-line idea, and you want to convert it into a film, so you'll have to first write the idea from 2 lines to 5 pages, 5 pages to 20 pages, then maybe rewrite it, again write it, rewrite it, then write a screenplay, and then start the screenplay process. What a book does for me is I get 300 pages of story, world, characters. So for a producer, the job is faster. So he's not starting from the first milestone. He's already crossed, say, 4 milestones. Now all he has to do is rework the story if required, and then turn that into the format that he needs. So it's just a faster, easier process. I don't think it's good or bad.
I'd like to add something to that. It's also, see, it's not just that there's a lack of talent, but you have to take it from the producer's point of view also. See, there are people, I know lots of us have been trying to market scripts and original ideas forever. But the trouble there is, when a producer is not going to, as Sid says, nobody reads. So 80 page ka ya 100 page ka script wo nahi padne wala hai. So then he's listening to your idea. Either he, on the basis of what you say in 2 pages, he imagines what it is going to be and gets the right idea or not. Here, he already knows ki iska book ban gaya hai, people have read it. So somewhere psychologically he feels assured ki isme dam hai. That's one of the problems. The problem is, which a lot of writers like us face, is that people don't want to try their hands on material which is not proven. So it could be a script, but because it's not published, they may not even look at it.
Public endorsement helps in people believing, maybe this is good, because you know other people are liking it.
But it may or may not have, like Anand just said, that for example, Sacred Games in question, I mean, there were a lot of other books also, I can, as a publisher, say it, that the book might not have sold as many copies.
Yeah.
But the producers found so much of faith in the script that they could reach out to millions of other audiences. It's all about finding the right platform.
Yeah, so they feel that at least there's some QC gone into the editing and worthy enough of being printed. Very few, I mean, thousands of books, hardly.
Yeah, absolutely.
Also,
yeah, it's very new. Also, it's still at very early
stage. Also, when a book is optioned or bought over, the rights are bought, the producer puts money into the development to hire another team of writers who are going to work on bringing it to screen, you know, book to screen. And the parameters to make it a success audiovisually is very different from what it is as a book. So there's so much also, you know, I mean, from the author's point of view, it could just be like, you've ruined my book. There are enough cases where we've heard an author has said, I have nothing to do with this. I'm, you know, disowning this film because it's not at all like what I've written. On the other side, there are a lot of authors who've benefited from books which may not have gotten that kind of publicity, but because the news came ki achha fala fala studio ya fala filmmaker ne ya on this platform is getting, it's been picked up, that now the sales of the book have gone up because people want to see, achha ye kya hai. They know ek saal baad humko series dikhegi, lekin pehle pad lete hain, chalo dekhte hain.
Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
The book sold much more after the HBO series happened.
Even Jurassic Park, for that matter.
Even Jurassic Park. Lord of the Rings.
Even Lord of the Rings, yeah.
Came back from nowhere, came back from the dead.
Yeah. I have a question for the authors here.
So I think Jyoti predominantly mentioned a bit of it. Now, the writers traditionally, be it new or established authors, have been thinking of stories and putting them on paper and getting out good stories in the market. And now with the word to screen market, you know, evolving, and you know, with whatever reasons we can think of, and with all the leading media houses jumping towards publishers, do we also see a trend towards new as well as established authors conjuring up stories with a bent of mind that, you know, they could be with a screen, what you call, a future, the future of being adapted to screen in mind? Do we see a trend? For example, Ravi here, if you were to write your next book, to the authors, I mean, for example, you have written books, but now, forget that you're a part of the industry already, but...
No, in my case, I think it, almost any book I write, I can see how it would play out as a script. So, and that's the way I guess I write it.
But
I think a lot, to answer your question, I think a lot of authors are now giving it that kind of thought, that if this, I see my book becoming a series, I see my book becoming a film, so how do I need to craft it that way? So I think that's definitely happening.
Do you think, the second part of the question is, do you think that it would hamper or not hamper the otherwise creative process or the story building?
It could. See, that's a subjective case-to-case scenario. I mean, definitely if you write a book with a script mentality, you may lose out on some of the detailing, some of the introspection. That's possible. So it's just a case to case.
I'll just add my experience. Most of the authors that I'm working with, which are a couple of hundred now, I think most of them now call and check with me, ki we are thinking of starting this book. What do you think? Will it work for screen? So I tell them, you know, if it's a good story, just write it anyway. It'll work for screen. If it's a bad story, even if I, you know, but I think, you know, there's no harm in picking your battles. I mean, I keep prodding Chatru. Okay, we start your next one. Let's talk.
Yeah, no, I completely agree. And one of the important things in this is that, see, as authors, we are constantly taking creative calls. Irrespective of whether ye film banega, TV series banega, you're always taking a creative call. Shall I kill off this character, not kill off this character? Will he get married, will he not get married? All those kind of calls we're anyway taking. Okay, so the process of eliminating a possibility and embracing another always exists. Now in that, there is only one new factor that has come in. Ki, now, can this also be an audiovisual story? So there is only one more addition to a multiple set of possibilities that we've always been struggling with and kind of dealing with. So it's just one more element, which is fun anyway, because at least, you know, as I go back to my famous thing, kam se kam paisa to milega. Yeah, we were.
I have a small question. Since it is a very powerful medium which is coming into being, what about censorship? Is there, how do you foresee censorship? Second question I have is, there was some talk about, you know, difference between the two media, like book, writing a book, and other thing is making a film or a web series or whatever it is. So, you know, they say that some people have visual imagination. Like some people may get it in words and he will be a very good writer. But there is some other group which can actually see it happen before his eyes. They say V. Shantaram was that type. He would not be able to write anything, but then he would immediately, if you tell him, he would be able to visualize that scene. So how do you see that? I think it is a different type of imagination which is required for a web series.
As you can see, nobody wants to answer this.
No, one sec. I would say that if a person has that kind of visual imagination, that person would be fantastic as a director or a cinematographer. More than, you know, the way they write is they should write with images. So that's what
I mean. It's a conflict of interest for an author to actually even admit or encourage somebody who can do visual imagination without writing it, because unke pet pe laad padegi.
No, the actual point is that a lot of good directors who have got who are able to see that vision, what they do is they get writers to do it for them. That's what they do, because they can't write it, but they get writers and say that, you know, this is what I want done. Now, I want it on paper because of XYZ reasons, I need clearances, whatever. So, you know, and there was a time when you didn't need a script and you could make a movie. I think even now you can, but I don't know how it is right now. You can, right? Okay, so then what are we doing here? So, and about censorship, I didn't understand what your question about censorship was.
I don't know. Popular web series discovery platform called Webisoda, and in that I have profiled around 500 Indian web series, and around 22 platforms. But I don't see a market for, I don't see that speculative fiction is that prominent. Like only 10 to 15 sci-fi or fantasy web series are there in India. Do you see the market for it? I am asking because I myself am a sci-fi writer.
Yeah, in the next few years, in fact, I'm developing a science fiction series based on a book. And it'll take time. I mean, it's too early to expect results. We don't live in an Instagram world. So it takes time. It takes 2 years, 3 years to get something going. But I think 5 years from now, you won't have to ask this question.
Okay. Thank you.
See, it's also one more thing. When you talk about sci-fi, you talk about fantasy or mythology, you're talking about huge budgets. You're talking about VFX. That becomes a deterrent. One, the timelines become much longer. You know, it's very easy to see Game of Thrones and see Star Trek and say that, but they've been doing that for 60, 70 years. The sci-fi market in India, even in cinema, is a little more nascent. It's happening, but it's going to take time because the investment is so much more.
Hello, sir. Why do our shows don't match the level of Friends in Breaking Bad?
Sorry.
Our shows don't match the level of Friends
in
Breaking
Bad. You know, you've just insulted three filmmakers sitting here, bro. Matlab, I'm protesting, I'm hungry, I'm going.
I mean, there is a very bad humor. There was a show named Office, which we adapted the Indian version and which got criticized very badly, really. So,
his question is, why aren't we, you know,
why aren't we making good content like Hollywood?
I'm going to reveal my age now and tell you that when there was only two channels, Doordarshan 1 and Doordarshan Metro, there was incredible, fabulous content. Okay? And even now, Sarabhai versus Sarabhai has its own fan club online. So there are people who are watching that, you know, little clips, and Rosesh has his own fan club and Maya has her own fan club. So, I mean, let's not, you know, there's enough, you know, stuff. But then a certain kind of content became popular. And then, you know, because there's a herd mentality, there are people who want to just... So, of course, your generation of kids has only seen that, or seen mummies watching that, or daddies watching that. So you think that's the level of, I'm sorry, I'm being very nasty right now. Don't take it personally. But I'm very old and I remember those shows, bro. So it's like...
No, to add to that, Jyoti, see, the reason the show she's talking about had good content was they were limited episode series. 13 episodes, 26 episodes. The minute you start doing a daily... Most of the stuff you're talking about is comparison to television. Friends is a television show. Breaking Bad is a television show. They were limited episodes. Here, where I'm writing a TV show, we are on episode 300. By the time you get to 300, you've run out of every idea in the book. The hero-heroine have done everything. I'm telling you, I have issues where the genie is putting the guy in the desert and somebody's turned around and say, "Arey, par 56 episode mein ye kiya tha." You run out of ideas, dude. And there are shows which are 10,000 episodes. What do you do? That's why with web series coming, you'll see quality improve. Because stories are finite. There's a beginning, middle, end. The minute you make them infinite, it's going to be this quality. You run out of stuff.
Thank you so much.
Also, I think the one point that we must remember is that while we have a movie like Dangal on one side, we also have Ramsey. Okay. So it's a wide market. You know, you've got... There is a market for all kinds of content. Okay. You can create content which I think is bad. It's true about books as well. Like you would turn around and say, "Acha, yaar, this guy is a terrible author. There's no point in reading him." But there's someone else who loves that author, right? So that's the nature of the business, and there are stories for everyone. It's nice that there are stories for everyone, as opposed to there being only one kind of stories, and that's good, I think.
Yeah, but the humor in Friends was so good, but
it doesn't matter. There are people who love humor in the show that you don't like.
Friends, yaar, kaun?
But there was Ye Jo Hai Zindagi. There was Kakka Ji Kahin. Even the early episodes of Office. There are a lot of good comic shows in India as well. It's just that once you get beyond 30, 40 episodes, you run out of stuff.
I want to add something. My bit on this, right, is that I agree with you. I don't think we have, enough people, you know, making the best content. And yeah, I agree with you. I agree with him. But see, there are few people like them who read. I can tell you from personal experience, I spent 5 years in Hollywood. And when I came here, I was shocked. In LA, every writer, director, actor I would meet would have a book in his hand. And when I came to Bombay and Andheri West, everybody had a DVD in their hand. And because of that, you know, the 15 years of
you know, the talent that we had in Bombay was churning out terrible stuff because they would not read enough. They were just trying to copy from the West, and that showed in all the content. It's only in the last, I think, 2, 3, 4 years that I've seen that more people have started reading, learning the craft, learning techniques, and, you know, more, you know, different writers who do other things as a daily job have started writing. And, you know, so I think this universe of, you know, talent has expanded now, become better. And I think the results will only be seen in the next few years. But yeah, I mean, we've gone through a terrible content time. And now also, I think it's very difficult to find.
You know, for example, okay, very seriously, I mean, if you're talking about Friends and Breaking Bad and all these, you know, really classic shows that come out of the West. And here, I mean, we also, I mean, we've got some great iconic shows that happened here in finite content. But we also have like zany YouTubers who are doing all kinds of stuff. TikTok is like a huge deal for your generation. I'm still picking on you. You're sitting, but I can see you still. Yeah, but seriously. But I mean, like, there's a market for everything. It wouldn't work if people were not investing time, money, energy, whatever in it.
Yeah, but Jyoti, we have to accept, you know, that we make bad content.
No, there is.
And we have to make great efforts to make it better.
No,
I think as an industry.
I think it's expression. I think it's freedom of expression. So everybody is entitled to make what they like. And if they think, okay, I'm becoming famous in my neighborhood because of that, great.
I think while the point on Friends and all is well made, but the point you need to keep in mind is that we end up comparing the best in the world with the riffraff in India as well. And then it happens in books as well. You tend to compare the best writers in the world with all the writers in India and say Indian writers are horrible and the Western writers are good. Yeah. You don't see the trash of the West in India. I think that's one of the reasons why you tend to believe. And two, I think also this is something which somebody from your previous organization told me. And that is, in India, all of us, most of us belong to the middle and the upper strata of the society. Whereas most of these serials and most of these episodes are also watched by people at the grassroots level. So what appeals to them and what appeals to you are very, very different things. So most of the television serials, which we just, you know, kind of squirm at, most of these television serials are loved by your drivers and maids.
No, that's
and they are the guys who drive television today and not you. I'm sorry to say, people sitting in this room do not drive television.
No, thank you, Ravi, because, okay, so no, very seriously, one very, very big channel, digital channel, actually told, me and a writer who had gone with me, that we are not looking at high-flown content, we're not looking at intellectual stuff, we want drivers and panwalas and security guards to watch it on their phones. Do you have, you know, like a Bhabhi Ji Ghar Par Hai, and, you know, that is our level of, they're very clear, it's a business call. And that is the kind of content that they were requesting, which obviously I couldn't go back with because I don't even watch Bhabhi Ji Ghar Par Hai. But yeah, but I think we're running out of time now. They're going to be calling in the next session. So thank you guys so much. This was great, but thank you for your question. It spiked up a lot of conversations here.